Now, talking about festive things, a big film in the cinemas, Boxing Day, Little Women. And Saoirse Ronan is the little woman making a huge impact in Hollywood, without a doubt, because this adaptation of Little Women is winning brilliant reviews, and it has even gained Saoirse her fourth Golden Globe nomination.
Congratulations.
And I am hoping come January, an Oscar nomination in there. But we can, but you know, we can pray for you.
That'd be good.
But the thing is, it's lovely to see you, first
it's
of all.
It's nice really to, good see to see you too.
But what I loved about this is a passion project for you. Mm. You wanted this role badly. Tell folks how you went about securing the role.
Yeah, so Greta Gerwig, the director, and I had done Lady Bird together, and I think that's the last time I was on speaking to you guys. And so we were doing press for the film, and we were at an award show in LA, and I had heard that she was going to follow it up with Little Women, which I just thought was, like, such an unusual, like, really exciting thing to follow up an indie with. And I was like, I have to be Joe. And I knew I had to be Joe, and I had to be her Joe. And so I went up to her and I just tapped her on the shoulder. And I was like, Greta, I know you're doing Little Women, and I just want to let you know that I'm going to be Joe in your Little Women, and I'll be there on September 1st. And I just thought I'd inform you of that. And she was like, she just goes, okay, I'll think about it. And I was like, that's not how I thought that was going to go.
How long did she think about it?
She thought about it for about a week.
Oh.
Just to make
about
you sweat.
I think so.
Yeah.
That's what I'm telling myself.
And then did she phone you?
She emailed me. She's so mean. No, she... Because, you know, there's a few different timelines in the film that she plays with, and I think she was still trying to figure out how she was going to do all that, but now eventually she said...
But anyway, you were thrilled. It was the part you wanted. As Eamonn said, you were very passionate. You got
it.
Very good. Do you know, there's so much... There have been so many adaptations of Little Women.
Yeah.
Puts pressure on you, of course. But if I remember with Joan March, and she's a writer and she goes off to New York or whatever to write, isn't there a sad scene where she has to sell her hair?
Yes.
Her hair. So I'm looking at your lovely hair in
I
that.
I know. She has beautiful hair for a while, and then she... basically, her mother, Marmee... It's set during the war, and during the Civil War, and so her mother, Marmee, has to go and tend to her father, who's away fighting in the war. And they're very, very poor. They're a poor family, and so she doesn't have the money for the fare. And Jo can't bear to go to rich Aunt March, who Meryl Streep plays, and so instead she sells her hair, and she comes back, and one of the other characters says, oh, Jo, that was your one beauty.
Just your one beauty
in order for her mom to go away. So we came up with a name for this particular wig, which was Pam, and it came from Florence Pugh, who plays Amy. And she was looking at me one day, and I had no shoes or socks on, and I was knitting offset, and I'm just like such an old woman anyway, and I had short hair, and she was like, you look like you should be called Pam, and like you're like, and so she started to be like Pam from Perth, and she had an Australian accent and had like a lot of opinions about everything.
You mentioned Meryl Streep there, so she plays the aunt. So you have a scene with her. how nervous were you? Did you have to play it really, like, very confident?
You know what? I was actually fine during the scene and before the scene, because it's such a funny moment between them, and there's no, like, drama. Nobody has to cry. Like, there was no real pressure. We could just kind of have fun with it. But then as soon as they called cut and they said we were going to move on to another scene, it just suddenly, like, all the emotion washed over me that I had gotten to work with Meryl, and I just, like, tried to just, like, hold her for a very long time and just, like, stare into her eyes and thank her for letting
me
act.
Did she have her dog on set with her?
She had a dog. It was the character's dog, and the character's dog is called Michael, and his name's actually Michael in real life, and he's a poodle. And Greta wanted to buy Michael because he was so adorable.
And it's like an ensemble cast from the point of view that you end up knowing people like Timothee, who we saw in the scene there. Because the last time we were speaking to you, it was about Lady Bird, and he was in that. Now, it was quite interesting. In Lady Bird, he breaks your heart.
He does.
In Lady Bird. But it's funny, fate has a way of payback, hasn't it?
Swings and roundabouts, because in Little Women, I got to break his heart into... 1,000 little pieces.
But you're...
I loved it. I'm not going to lie.
And you like messing up his hair, which he's not very fond of doing. No,
he lets me do it. I think inside he's like, get away from me. But Timothy is very proud of his hair.
And what about the rest of the cast? We've got Emma Watson, Eliza Scanlon, Florence Pugh. Mm. You know, it's...
And so Greta was so fantastic at, like, not putting a lid on that. She just sort of let that tumble into the scene. So we were just always like mm-hmm. that. And everything that you see of us when we're younger, especially, is exactly how we all are when we're together.
But what your director did differently with so many previous adaptations of this is she starts the film not at the very beginning when you're all young girls.
No.
She starts halfway through.
Yeah, so she's the first image. The first image of the movie is a shot of Joe's back, and she sort of she looks quite masculine, very square shoulders, and she's about to go into an editor's office for the first time and sell her friend's story. And so the film is bookended by scenes in that office where, at the beginning, she is not confident, she hides the fact that she's actually written these stories, and at the end, this is where Louisa May Alcott's story becomes a real part of our film, and she bargains with this editor and fights for her copyright, which is something that Louisa May Alcott, who wrote the book, actually did. And I think it's
then was quite phenomenal, because women were, really were there to be married off, weren't you? That
right,
was the whole
absolutely.
Premise of Little Women.
It's like it's an economic proposition, is what we say in the film. But I mean, there's such a thing right now of, like, Taylor Swift just released an album, and this is the first album she's ever owned, and none of her other music belongs to her. And the fact that Louisa May Alcott 150 years ago knew to fight for her copyright is like revolutionary. So we really wanted to use this as an opportunity to, like, honour that and honour this woman who knew to fight for her work, you know?
So a modern message in all of this. Do you play the characters with more modernity, if you're with me? I mean, your character Jo, do you play her as if, you know, she's part of the American Civil War, or do you think she's, you know, citizen of 2020?
Well, both. I mean, I think the thing is that there's so many period films that we've watched from the past, and the sort of style that they're done in, the acting style and the way they're filmed is quite, it's sort of almost like it's based on a portrait or a painting, and it can be quite stiff and stale. And they probably, you know, didn't talk like this when they back then. They probably did speak pretty similarly to us. And so with the way Greta's written it, like, we overlap each other all the time. We talk as fast as I'm talking right now.
Your sisters
would young.
All do as well.
Yeah, exactly. There's like four conversations going on at the one time. So I think it's modern, but it's also probably more similar to how it would have
been. Listen, it's a fantastic cast. You're always fabulous in everything you
Thank
do.
You.
And congratulations on your nominations as well. Can't wait to see it. That is Little Women. It's out in cinemas on Boxing Day. Talking of Christmas, so have you got some time off now? You're going home?
This is my last day of press.
Is it?
And I'm going to sleep after this. I'm going to get into my pyjamas. Someone told me these look like pyjamas, so I might just
How
stay
rude.
In these.
Who said that?
Someone I won't mention. Well, look, but anyway.
It's brilliant. You finished on a high.
I finished on exactly.
Exactly.
Couldn't get any better.
Couldn't
well,
get any
enjoy
better.
Being in your pyjamas.
Thanks.
Have a rest.
You too.
And come back and see us anytime.
Sisha,
you know, we'd love to see
always
you.
Enjoy hearing about your success and your
Thank
projects.
You.
Absolutely amazing. Thank you very much.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.